Joining me now here on the MMA Report is a man who's stepping up on short notice of fight here at the Combates America show in Fresno, California on February the 28th. Hector, man, appreciate time, a short notice opportunity. You just signed the bout agreement here this week.
Yeah.
Pros and cons of a short notice fight.
Man, well, the thing with me is I literally stay ready all year round. No joke. As soon as I got done with my last fight, I had this date circled. So I was already mentally preparing for this date, whether I had an opponent or not. This time they cut it real close, but I had physically, mentally, I was ready regardless. So as far as like short notice opportunities, doesn't really matter. Like I said, I stay ready. Some of the cons, though, just rushing. The only con on short notice fights is rushing my corner schedule, because at Alpha Male we have so many coaches, and all our coaches have mixed schedules because we have so many fighters in our gym. So figuring out like who's available and trying to be courteous as far as like trying to get them on the times that I need them, you know, making sure they're not out of town or making sure, you know, they're not already obligated to cornering somebody else. So that's honestly the only con I could think about as far as short notice. But other than that, I mean, I'm ready. I'm very familiar with Shane. He's fought one of my teammates, so this was a very easy choice for me.
You know, going through your Instagram and the latest post you had up there, you wrote, 2 years ago on this day, I left the Bay, a great full-time job, comfort, stability, things you don't give up at 29 for a complete restart, and no guarantee that things will work out. I wouldn't change a damn thing so far. Happiest I've ever been in my life, and I'm just getting started. As you think about when you made this decision to change what you're doing, obviously that can be a stressful thing of like, hey, is this going to work out? Like, as you kind of think about the last 2 years, how would you say you have grown, not just as a martial artist, but also as a person?
Man, exponentially, to be honest. Coming out here, I had honestly made the decision mentally. I was prepared to, I was honestly just taking it a year at a time. I'm like, goal number one, to come out here, maximize and see how I'm doing after a year, give it a year. You know, if things are going great financially, physically, and mentally, cool, we're going to keep going. The first year was tough. It was a big rebuild year for me, but it was excellent. It was great. I felt pretty stabilized after the first year. Going into the second year, I felt like I had a pretty big breakout. I felt great. It's the best I've ever felt truthfully in my life. And now I'm just running with it year by year. But, yeah, as a person I've grown, it's just I've left my comfort zone. Like, I've been in the Bay Area I've never left home before that, honestly. Like I said, I had a very stable job, college grad. So as a college grad with a good job and a great opportunity, you just don't leave things like that. Or at least people never recommend that you leave things like that for something that's so uncertain. So it really just grew, you know, believing in myself and betting on myself. Like, I'm not much of a betting man, but I'm always going to bet on myself. So that's definitely one thing. It's just testing my perseverance for sure. Cause honestly, I'm in the toughest room in the world. And the thing is I'm in there every single morning. I don't miss a day. So, I mean, that's just a test of my dedication and just taking everything seriously as possible. No distractions. I'm literally like, I got asked earlier, what are my hobbies? I'm like, I honestly don't have time for hobbies because I'm either training or I'm working, one or the other. So it's like, well, I'm 24/7 committed into the game.
Is it tough to get your mind off the fight game?
No, not at all. Actually, I love it. It's not hard at all. I'm obsessed with it, and it's like, I'm obsessed with my progression because it's like I feel like I progress so much in such a short amount of time. So I'm constantly hungry to get better, hit the next level. I'm a big Dragon Ball Z fan, so it's like that training mentality of like continuously training, finding a new level, and trying to ascend to it. You know, the next level, and just trying to be better. That's honestly carried me out. That's made me really hungry. So it's it's one of those things where it doesn't feel like work to me at all.
I think one of the interesting things in researching you that really stuck out to me was looking at your Tapology page and seeing the amateur career, up and down amateur career, but as a pro, mm-hmm. everything's gone tremendous for you. Is there anything you can point to towards of why you've had the record you've had as a pro, but that wasn't necessarily the case as an amateur?
Yeah, no, it was a bit of a learning curve because I started really late, just in general. And if you look at my record, everyone's pretty tough. There's at least, I mean, I fought Pat Mix, you know, Nolan Hernandez, he's in the UFC, fought guys in the top ranked in the state as far as top 10 ranked. I fought quite a few guys there. So every test had been tough, and I knew that. But a lot of those losses were decisions, were close decisions, or just situations where I was out. Like, I wasn't ready. You know, I was outplaced. But the thing as far as amateurs is concerned, I've always kept it in my mind that it's like, okay, you know, pro is a goal. It's going to restart, you know, these struggles and whatnot. It's for a bigger goal. So it's just really just staying persistent. And honestly, when I made the move over to Alpha Male, I knew that was going to be the biggest key because I knew I was a good striker. I knew I was a good grappler. My biggest problem was blending everything together and my wrestling. And Alpha Male, that's going to fix that no matter what. And again, I'm in the room with the best, the best guys in there. I'm going to see the best wrestlers, the best grapplers, and I'm going to see the best strikers in there too. So I feel like it's just being in there has taken my game to a whole nother level, and it's cleared up a lot of problems that I had as an amateur. So it's like, man, as soon as my first pro fight, like every pro fight that I've gone into, it's like none of those guys is tougher. None of these guys are tougher than my Monday morning.
Yeah.
So knowing that, it's honestly feel like my corners will call out. It's just another day of practice. It honestly feels like another day of practice when I'm out there. Because I've been in a lot of big situations as an Emmy. I fought in a lot of big stages as an amateur. Done a few televised fights as an amateur. So that prepared me as far as the nerves, as far as being, you know, behind on the lights and on the stage. But everything else just got filed down with just a lot of hard work and persistence, just being patient and following the program. Again, Alpha Male has helped a lot with that.
We've mentioned about your opponent, you know, Shane Torres, and you mentioned about how he's fought a teammate. When you hear the name Shane Torres, is there something that just pops in your mind immediately?
He's tough. He's tough. He's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. He's a solid wrestler. So I know he's going to be a pretty good grappler. But again, I see great grapplers on the regular. I see great MMA fighters on the regular. I think the key is, in this game nowadays, it's not kind of like the old days where it's like, you can win completely on being a specialist. I think you have to have a much more well-rounded game. And I think that's actually been the thing that's helped me out the most, is that my game's very well rounded. But again, what I see when I hear Shane, he's a well versed grappler, you know, so I don't take him lightly in that department.
In terms of your nickname, El Matador, how do we get it?
Yeah. You know, what's funny is, it's one of those things where you never give yourself a nickname ever. So as soon as I got it, I ran with it. So this is this story. It was like back in my judo days at San Jose State. It was everyone kind of knew that I watched a lot of mixed martial arts on the team. Mm-hmm. Like, that was my thing. I was very big on following it. And they used to do these mock tournament matches on Fridays where they're like, they pick two random guys on the team and then make a spectacle or a match out of it. And then like, I'd write it on the board and announce it like before practice, just to kind of make it more fun. And it'd be a surprise match. So one of my coaches, was joking and wrote it on the board, like literally wrote it on the board. It was just like Hector El Matador Fajardo, and again, it's like so-and-so, so-and-so, like just as a joke. And I ran with it. As soon as I saw it on the board, I was like, oh, that's dope. I was like, yeah, I'm sticking with it. I'm like, you can't take that away. Another one too is like I like during that time I liked watching Roger Huerta a lot. So the name for that, you know, old school name back on his UFC run, like I liked watching him a lot. He fought with a lot of heart. So, you know, it kind of clicked there. And so that's kind of how it stuck. As soon as he dropped that name, I'm like, oh, I'm running with it. Now people would see me put it on like Facebook or Instagram or something like that, and they'd be like, what the hell? Like, how are you calling yourself that? I'm like, I'm not calling myself that. That name was given. So it, you know, it didn't break any rules.
Do you remember, you know, or time range of when you first watched an MMA fight?
Yeah, actually, the first time, you know, the funny thing about that is actually I was a very heavy boxing head. So back when the discussion of like what's, you know, what's safer, what's better, like MMA or boxing, like I was originally very heavy boxing head, because I'm like looking at this MMA stuff, I'm like, what the hell is this? Like, you know, so I would, you know, I would see a little bit of Chuck and Tito, like a couple highlights here and there. I really didn't start really getting into it until honestly I went to a Strike Force fight. It was Thompson Melendez, I believe it was the second one. Someone got free tickets to that fight, to that card, that Strike Force card in San Jose. And I just went and I got hooked. I saw that show and I'm like, oh my gosh, like this is so dope. Like this is pretty cool. So watching that was a big start. And then I mean, there's a lot of Bay Area guys in there too. So I actually saw like a couple, like one or two guys that are like new from high school, and I'm like, what the heck? These guys are fighting in a cage. Like this is insane. Like that got me hooked. But then I really, really got hooked on UFC after watching UFC 87. I think that was the biggest, that was my first UFC show that I like watched. And then after that, I was like, okay, this is pretty cool. And just, that's when I started following from there. After 87, just every time a UFC came out, I started keeping tabs and just watching, and then just hooked, and then just blew up in my mind.
Yeah, for me, it was my brother bringing home a VHS tape of
Oh,
UFC
yeah.
one, you know, and from Blockbuster. So for the younger audience out there, they probably don't know what Blockbuster is, but yeah, we actually went to a video
That's my time.
store.
That's right around my time too.
Yeah, that was my first, and then it kind of just it evolved from there. But yeah, it's always kind of interesting to see how the community, whether you know, you as a fighter or me on the media side or just a regular fan, how they discovered this sport. It's always kind of interesting because it's different timetables for everyone.
No, 100%. And it's funny because it's like set, like being in your surroundings, you tend to find things that are around you. Like again, I went to San Jose State. When I went there, I had no aspirations of doing any kind of martial arts, any kind of mixed martial arts. Like I didn't even know what it was, to be honest. And once I started, I took a PE judo class, and that's what kickstarted me into everything. Started falling in love with that as a martial arts. But being at San Jose State, that we're right next door to AKA. So we had a lot of AKA fighters there, a lot of MMA guys, a lot of heavy jiu-jitsu guys. So it's like I'm sitting there like hearing these names and wondering like what the hell are they talking about? Who the hell are they talking about? And then it's like you do your research on that, and then you see him on TV and you're like, oh my gosh, that guy's like from nearby. Like this guy's from this gym nearby. Like you start figuring out like, oh my gosh, this guy's like really close. So once you start seeing around your surroundings and stuff like that, and you start to pick up, and then it's infectious after that.
But of course, we look forward to seeing your fight here coming up next week at Combates America, Mexico versus USA. Of course, main card airs live on Access TV. Hector, really appreciate the time. Good luck here in the fight. Of course, let me know anything, follow you on social media and anybody else you want to shout out.
Yeah, big shout out to Team Alpha Male, of course, first and foremost. It's where I train. It's where you know, it's my home. That's actually where I'm going to train in about 30, 40 minutes. I've got wrestling practice today. And then a big shout out to CSA. That's a big piece of my training as well. I train there on the weekends. It's really upped my striking and being able to blend everything. Shout out to my family, friends that support me. Shout out to Iridium Sports. It's been behind my back. You know, we're on a good run, and I love it right now. Super happy with everything that's going on with them. Again, I'm excited to be on Combate again. Every time I'm on Combate, I put on a show. A year ago, I was on that Fresno card. I put on a show, you know. So I'm excited. I'm actually more excited, more than anything, to go back to somewhere that I've had a lot of success. I always say I Fresno always brings good things for me. So I'm undefeated in Fresno since my amateur career. So fun fact. So yeah, man, I'm excited to get this going. I live it. I'm ready for it, and hope my opponent is too.